This endowment is under the name of D. Sri D. Ramakrishna Iyer, instituted by his son, Sri P. R. Kannan. Sri D. Ramakrishna Iyer was a Vedic scholar belonging to the school of Samaveda. And his brother, Appadurai Dikshitar, was a well-known Samavedin and was honored by Kanchi Paramacharya in the Mutt. And Sri Ramakrishna Iyer himself was well-versed in many branches of studies, and he was teaching in a school in Chidambaram. He was deeply immersed in our tradition, in Shiva Puja, in always praying to Lord Nataraja in the temple there, and also teaching many students. And Sri P. R. Kannan, who had M.Tech degree in structural, civil and structural engineering from IIT Madras, and also a PG diploma from Holland, has just now joined Sri P. R. Kannan. Welcome to you, sir. And he has been working in various capacities in many multinational companies in India and abroad. But his interest in Sanatana Dharma was so profound that he has been giving a lot of lectures, pravachanas, and he had been blessed with many titles, including by Kanchi Periva. He has himself written many books, including Sri Jayendra Vijayam. He has translated many books, and he has written commentaries on many books also. Some of his publications are, he has translated Venkatachala Mahatmyam from Skanda Purana, and also Shivagiti Mala with the commentary Shiva Ashtapati by Sri Chandrasekharendra Saraswati, the 62nd Shankaracharya of Kanchi Kamakoti Pita. Commentary on our Narayana Bhattatri's Sripada Saptati. And also he has translated many books, the commentary on Sri Rudram and Chamakam. And also he has made an English commentary and translation on Smriti Muktapala, especially the Varnashrama Kanda. And he has also translated many other books, including Sri Lalita Trishati and many slokas on Ambal and Rama Ashtapadi. He has also composed many slokas, and he is a very close associate of Sri Kanchi Mutt, and Periva has been asking him to give a lot of lectures and talks, upanyasams across India, and which he has been doing so faithfully. He is also writing so many articles in journals and magazines like Dilip and other such magazines to bring out the salient features of Sanatana Dharma. And he also encourages a lot of others and many of our research scholars also to write in Dilip, a magazine from Mumbai. And I request on his behalf our own scholars to contribute articles on different aspects of Sanskrit literature, Sanatana Dharma, to this magazine. You can send it to KSRI email ID. We will forward it to P. R. Kannan. And thanks to him, we have been conducting annual lectures under this endowment. And he has also created a fund for carrying out a project in memory of his father. And Professor Parthasarathi, former professor of geography in DBJ in College Chennai, and presently honorary professor at our research institute, is working on the project Evolution of Earth, called out from the Puranas. So it's a very interesting project also. So thanks to Sri P. R. Kannan sir for giving this endowment, instituting this endowment of our institute, and also for joining us today. I also make my humble pranams to all those who are assembled here. Our president is there, Justice Madam and all others are there. And today, you know, the first lecture was given by Dr. K. Srinivasan on the Vedic literature, Brahmanas. Second lecture was given by Professor Partha Sarathy. Third lecture last year was given by Lalita Madam on Bhasa's drama. And this year, we have got another eminent personality who is well versed in Sanskrit as well as mathematics, a rare combination. She did her post-graduation in Sanskrit from Dharwad University. Most of us know Dr. K. Krishnamurthy was associated with this university. She had wonderful teachers like Professor Shambhag and others. And she came to KSRI, and she is the niece of our former secretary C.P. Madhavan, who told us that she would be interested in doing PhD here. And she chose an interesting subject on Bija Pallava of Bhaskara too, with the commentary and of Krishna Devajnya. And this PhD was appreciated by many scholars, especially from the professor Hayashi in Japan. And subsequently, it was published, and within short time, it underwent 5 editions. And not stopping with that, Dr. Sita Sundaram has been giving a glimpse of ancient Indian mathematics in many schools in Chennai, and also conducting quiz in Ramayana. And she has been giving lectures on many aspects of ancient Indian mathematics in many IITs and learned bodies across India. And also she has given lectures in many parts of the world, including Mexico and also in USA. She is a much sought after scholar in the field of ancient Indian mathematics. She has worked on many projects in ancient Indian mathematics. She is presently the secretary of our research institute. And thanks to her venture into ancient Indian mathematics, it has prompted many other scholars to follow. And we had Dr. Rama Kalyani Madam, who also did PhD in ancient Indian mathematics at the KSRI. And presently, we have got 2 more scholars working on different aspects of ancient Indian mathematics. And another person submitted his PhD, waiting for the Vaibhavos, on Sripati and Sridhara's work in ancient Indian mathematics. We had 1 MPhil also on Karani, the research. Like that, she has inspired many scholars, and she has also conducted workshops at our own institute as well as on behalf of the Samskrit Academy in Kanchipuram University, Ennathur, and where many scholars from India and abroad personally came and presented papers, and the proceedings would be brought out soon. So she has got a lot of credentials as a scholar in Sanskrit as well as in mathematics, ancient Indian mathematics. More than that, she has been one among us participating in all our, you know, activities, daily activities after C.B. Madhavan, with her motherly care and affection. And we really are happy and proud that we are associated with you, madam. And today we are assembled here to listen to her. It is a very unfortunate situation that the so-called Tamil, those who speak of Tamil, greatness of Tamil, the Dravidians or politicians or Tamil scholars, never tried to bring out the glory of our ancient Tamils in the field of mathematics or ancient science or architecture, things like that. On the contrary, many Sanskrit scholars have brought out the glory of Tamil literature and language. For example, Dr. P.S. Subramanya Sastri did the pioneering work on ancient Indian Tamil grammar. Tulkapiyam was first translated by him and published by the KSRI. And here is Dr. Swetha Sundar Raman, who had done a lot of work on this particular text, Asthana Kolahalam, a Tamil text on Indian mathematics. And there is another text called Kanakadigaram. So she has been trying to propagate the contribution of ancient Sanskrit as well as Tamil to many fields of studies, especially mathematics. And on behalf of the KSRI, I welcome you all for this talk. And now I request Dr. Swetha Sundar Raman Madam to take over and then give her endowment lecture. Thanks to you, Madam, once again. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Balasubramaniam. It was a very kind word. I am looking at it as an opportunity to make people know about such texts which are very few in number. Tamil Nadu is a land of temples. The architecture is complex and unique to each temple. It is therefore surprising that there are no mathematical treatises available explaining the diverse calculations involved. Some time ago, when research was being done on Kanakadiharam, meaning text on mathematics, three manuscripts were found bearing the name Asthana Kolakalam. 930, 1327 and 1475 in the Tanjavur Saraswati Mahal Library. Moreover, there was an edited text of the same name in the Government Oriental Manuscript Library, Madras. Another manuscript, number 436, was also discovered in the GOML, having the same name. The mathematical text in Tamil by the name Asthana Kolakalam seems to be a compilation of the text and above manuscripts of the same name. It has been well edited and explained by Dr. K. Satyabhama. Lot of credit to her, who she is very much interested in both Tamil literature and mathematics. The text has been published by the Tanjavur Saraswati Mahal Library in 2004. One of the verses mentions the name of the author. Next, Lavanya. One of the verses mentions the name of the author of the text as Navali Perumal, son of Nagan. But there is no mention of the date. We still do not know even the rough date of the text. Koodalil Nagan gunam pera vanitta aadavar thooril Navali Perumal paadalai baanar paadam panivon naadavar nagaikka nayandurethene. Many colloquial words are found in Asthana Kolakalam. For example, naapadu for naarpadu and so on. We also come across some technical terms. Not surprising because it is a mathematical text. For example, marupagam denotes the product of two dissimilar numbers. Let's say for x into y. Binna kanakku refers to the arithmetic of fractions. And padiyadi togai means the sum of an arithmetic series and so on. Binna also refers to fraction in Sanskrit. The text begins with the customary invocation to Lord Ganesha. Ikkanakil ondrum edayoru varamal mukkanartham petra mudalvane ikkumoli kana kuravalli kavalarku munvanda gnanamugane arul. Let this work on mathematics proceed without any obstacles by the grace of Lord Ganesha, son of the three-eyed Shiva and the elder brother of Subramanya. Next. Some of the interesting topics which are taken into consideration by me appear in the same order as they given in the text. Next. Lavanya, next. Alavaihal, measures. Numerals are from 1, 10, 100 up to 1 crore in powers of 10, then they are in terms of crores. 1 crore is a Mahakoti. 1 crore Mahakoti is a Sangam, and so it goes up to Maha Arpudam, which is 10 power 231. So we have a unique word in Tamil for 10 power 231. Next slide, please. Next slide, please.
I think he, yeah.
Ma'am,
comparative measures. Athana Kolakalam gives 2 kannimai oru kainodi, 2 kainodi oru matirai, 2 matirai oru guru, 11 guru oru uyir, 6 uyir oru vinadikai, 60 vinadikai oru nadikai, 7.5 nadikai oru jamam, 3 jamam oru poludu, 2 poludu oru naal, 30 naal oru tingal, 12 tingal oru aandu. The same thing, similar measures are given in Satratamala, Sanskrit text of the 16th century. Lotus pricking time is equal to 1 thruti, 100 thruti is equal to 1 lava, 100 lava is equal to nimesha, that is twinkling of the eye, 400 nimesha is equal to 1 gurvakshara, 4 gurvakshara is equal to 1 kashta, 2.5 kashta is equal to 1 prana, roughly equal to 4 seconds. 6 prana is equal to 1 vigatika, 60 vigatika is equal to 1 gatika, 60 gatika is equal to 1 dina, 30 dina is equal to 1 masa, and then 12 masa is equal to 1 savana abda or a year. Next, Chaturanga Vivaram. Here, if on the 64 squares in the chessboard, grains are placed as follows, 2 in the first square, 2 squared in the second square, and so on, the number of grains in the last square, the 64th square, will be this big number. 8-8 arubatthu nalare amahil, 8-8 kundu mudalaga vittida, irattitha nelladane eengura innendrel, murattitha moodarivinar. It will be 18,447 Mahakoti, 42,370 Koti, 95 Laksham, and 50,616. You must have heard of this king who promised to give the impoverished poor 1 grain per square on the chessboard. So finally he had to give this much grain, and his granary was empty by the time he could pay the impoverished poor. Next, Padiyadi Togai, arithmetic progression and series called Shredi Vyavahara in Sanskrit. Adi Undru Mudal Anbadin Varai, Shredi Yantogai Sheppidil Pat Tanjai, Padi Seidarai, Pangudan Kuti, Munnidi Yanade, Ratina Churukame. Suppose you want to find the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 10, it is actually 10 into the next number, 10 plus 1 divided by 2, equal to 55, same as the modern formula, n into n plus 1 by 2. Similarly, if you want to find the sum of 1 up to 100, it is 100 into 101 by 2, which is 5050. Next. Now he gives a method to find the sum of odd numbers. Let us take the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. ஒன்று தொடங்கி 10 அளவு தொகையில் ஒற்றித்த தொகை எத்தனை எனில், தட் இஸ் 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9, ஒற்றித்த தொகைக்கு 10 உடனே கூட்டி பெருக்கின தொகையில் 5 களைய நீக்கு 50, இதனை பாதி செய்ய 25, ஆதலால் ஒற்றித்த தொகை 25 என்பது. டேக் த சம் ஆஃப் 1 up to 10, which is 55. Remove 5 from it and divide by 2 to get 25, which is the required sum of the 5 odd numbers. Next. So they have given a small proof. Let the series be 1, 2, 3 up to 2n. So the number of odd terms will be n. Now find the sum of 1 plus 2 plus up to 2n, which means 2n into 2n plus 1 by 2. And dividing by 2, you get n into 2n plus 1. Subtract the number of terms n from above. You are left with 2n squared. Divide the result by 2 and you get n squared. This is the sum of the odd numbers. If there are 5 odd numbers, you get 5 squared as the result. If you have 10 odd numbers, this 10 squared will be the result. Next. Next. Even numbers, 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10. ஒன்று தொடங்கி 10 அளவும் தொகையில் இரட்டித்த தொகை எத்தனை எனில் இரட்டித்த தொகையில் பாதி 5 என்றது. உடனே 1 கூட்ட 6. இதனை 10 பெருக்க 60. இதனை பாதி செய்ய 30. ஆதலால் இரட்டித்த தொகை 30 என்பது. The number of terms is 5, multiply by 10 after adding 1, which is equal to 60. Half of that is equal to 30, which is the required sum. Next. Next.
Animation irukkanaala slide poradhukku konja time aagum.
So let the series be 1, 2, 3 up to 2n. The number of even terms is n. Now find the product of 2n and n plus 1, which is 2n into n plus 1. We divide by 2, you get n into n plus 1, which is the required sum. So if there are 5 equal numbers, it is 5 into 6, that is the required sum. Next. Now we have come to some miscellaneous exam, very interesting examples. It's something similar to a game which we used to play when we were young. It's a Chiruvar Sirumiyar Kanakku, the boys and girls problem. So think of a number of boys B and a number of girls G. Add 2 to B and then double it. Add 1 to this, multiply by 5 and add G to it. Multiply this by 10 and subtract 250 from this. You now have a number whose 100th place is boys and 10th place is girls. So example, B is equal to 7, G is equal to 6. You do as he say, 7 plus 2 equal to 9, 9 into 2 equals 18, 18 plus 1 equals 19, 19 into 5 equals 95, 95 plus 6 equals 101, 101 into 10, 1010. You subtract 250 from this, you get 760. So B is equal to 7, which is boys, and G is equal to 6, the number of girls. I have given a proof. Next. Let the numbers be B and G. Add 2 to B, which is B plus 2. Double it, 2B plus 4. Add 1, 2B plus 5. Multiply by 5, 10B plus 25. Add G, 10B plus 25 plus G. Multiply by 10, 100B, 250, 10G. Subtract 250, you get 100B and 10G. So the 100th place is the boys' number and the 10th place is the girls' number. Next. Palarchulai kanakku, pulps in the jackfruit. Very interesting. Thoongu palavin chulayirai vendumendral, kambarihe nirkum kadirmullai, பாங்குடனே எட்டெட்டால் மாறி இலி நாவலர் கீய திட்டென்ன தோன்றும் சுளை. இஃப் தேர் ஆர் என் தான்ஸ் இன் த ஸ்டாக் ஆஃப் த ஜாக் ஃப்ரூட், தென் மல்டிப்ளை பை 64 அண்ட் டிவைட் திஸ் பை 8 டு கெட் த நம்பர் ஆஃப் பல்ப்ஸ். தட் இஸ் இஃப் த நம்பர் ஆஃப் தான்ஸ் இஸ் என், த நம்பர் ஆஃப் பல்ப்ஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு என் இன்டு 64 பை 8 பல்ப்ஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் டைம் யூ பை பலாப்பழம் யூ கேன் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட், யூ கேன் செக் வித் த பலாப்பழம் ஃபெல்லோ வெதர் திஸ் இஸ் கரெக்ட். Next. பெருங்குழி கணக்கு, வால்யூம் ஆஃப் த பிட். கொண்ட அடியெட்டால் குழியும் ஒரு 400, கண்ட கோல் குழி காணுங்கால் விண்டுதுரி எட்டதனே மாறி என்ற குழியில் தாக்கி தொட்ட குழி ஈந்து சரி சொல். A pit has a square bottom of side 8 அடி and depth 400 குழி. If another bit of the same volume has a depth of 100 kuri, what is the length of the side of the second pit? So let S be the side of the second pit. Volume of the first pit is 8 into 8 into 400, which is 25,600. Volume of the second pit, we don't know S. S into S into 100. Now give the solution, Ma. So 8 into 8 into 400 is equal to S into 100. Therefore, S squared is equal to 25,600 by 100, which is 256. Therefore, S is equal to square root of 256, which is 16 adi. Next. Nellin vilai, grains of rice. Pannirandu padinal mukkal panam enna. எண்களம் எத்தனை பொன்னெண்ணில் அது தன்னதா நடுவங்கடையும் தாக்கியே முன்னம் ஈந்து முடியும் கணக்கிதே. இஃப் கிரெயின் மெஷரிங் 12 படி காஸ்ட் 3/4 பணம், வாட் இஸ் த காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் 8 கலம் கிரெயின்? நம் பணம் இஸ் அ டினாமினேட்டன் ஆஃப் மணி, நாட் ஜென்ரல் மணி. ஹியர் 1 கலம் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 990 படி, விச் மீன்ஸ் 8 கலம் இஸ் 720 படி. Therefore, if grain of 12 padi cost 3/4 panam, the cost of 720 padi is, give the answer, 720 into 3/4 by 12, which is 45 panam. Next. Veldi in sherkai, addition of silver. When a little silver is added, we want to find how much has been added. மேலான ஒன்பதரை மாத்து நான்கு விராகனிலே ஏலான வெள்ளி இதனோடு இருக்க வேண மாத்தில் நூலாக மந்தனில் முன்மாத்து பொன்னினிடையே இருக்கு பாலாம் சிதம்புக்கு மாத்து கீது பகர்வாய் என்னே. A little silver is added to 4 viragan of 9.5 carat gold. It now became 8 carat gold. How much silver was added? So multiply the initial carat 9.5 and 4 to make 38. Divide this by 8 to get 4 3/4 virahan. Now 4 has become 4 3/4. Therefore, 3/4 virahan was added. Next. Now we come to Muttagai Kanakku, rule of 3. It is called Trairashika in Sanskrit. If we are working 30 days, a worker gets 1 pun, 8 3/4 panam. How long should the worker work to get 15 pun? Now, 1 pun is equal to 10 panam. So the answer would be 30 into 15 divided by 8 3/4, which is equal to 240 days or 8 months. Another example, ஓரட்டு மாத்தில் ஒரு வராகன் பணமே, நேரிட்ட நாலேழாம் நீயாறு மாத்துக்கு. பேரிட்ட முன்னிரண்டும் பெருக்க முதல் மூன்றும் நீரிட்ட தாக்கி நிறுத்தின தொகை ஈவீரே. இவ் ஒன் வராகன் ஆஃப் 8 மாத்து கேரட் காஸ்ட் 28 பணம், ஃபைண்ட் த காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் 1 வராகன் ஆஃப் 6 மாத்து. கிவ் த ஆன்சர் மா. ரிக்வயர்ட் காஸ்ட் இஸ் 28 இன்டு 6 பை 8, விச் இஸ் 21 பணம். நெக்ஸ்ட், ஐந்தொகை கணக்கு, ரூல் ஆஃப் 5, பஞ்சராசிகா இன் சான்ஸ்கிரிட். தெர் வாஸ் எ டெம்பிள் இன் அ சிட்டி அண்ட் ஃபார் லைட்டிங் 660 லேம்ப்ஸ் 1 நாழி ஆஃப் ஆயில் வாஸ் கிவன் அண்ட் த லேம்ப்ஸ் பேர்ன் ஃபார் 7.5 நாழிகை. ஒன் டே தெர் வாஸ் லெஸ் ஆயில், ஸோ 10 லேம்ப்ஸ் வெர் கிவன் அண்ட் ஒன்லி அ குவார்ட்டர் நாழி ஆயில் வாஸ் கிவன். ஹவு லாங் வுட் த லேம்ப்ஸ் பேர்ன்? ஸோ யூ மஸ்ட் மேக் அ டிஃபரன்ஸ் ஆஃப் 1 நாழி ஆஃப் ஆயில் quantity of oil and naalige is the time. It's a case of proportion with 5 quantities. Here lamps and time are in inverse proportion and oil and time are in direct proportion. Give the answer, ma. So 60 by 10 into 1/4 into 7.5 is equal to 11 1/4 naalige. This is the time the lamps would burn. Next. ஏழு தொகை கணக்கு, ரூல் ஆஃப் 7. 10 வயதிலே எட்டு கூத்தும் ஆறு திருகும் ஆடுவாளுக்கு சம்பளம் பொன் பத்தாக, அஞ்சு வயதினிலே நாலு கூத்தும் மூணு திருகும் ஆடுவாளுக்கு சம்பளம் எத்தனை? ஆப்வியஸ்லி திஸ் திருகு மீன்ஸ் அ கைண்ட் ஆஃப் டான்ஸ் வி டோன்ட் நோ. இஃப் அ டென் இயர் ஓல்ட் கேர்ள் வில் டான்ஸ் எயிட் கூத்து அண்ட் ஆறு திருகு அண்ட் ஏர்ன் பத்து பொன், வாட் வில் அ ஃபைவ் இயர் ஓல்ட் கேர்ள் டான்ஸிங் நாலு கூத்து அண்ட் மூணு திருகு ஏர்ன்? Proportion again with five quantity, seven quantities. So earnings is equal to 5 by 10 into 4 by 8 into 3 by 6 into 10, which is 10 by 8. Oru pon, 2.5 panam. Next. Onbadhu thogai, rule of 9, Navarashika. Kalmula ganathil, அரைமுழ பரப்பில் நாலு முழ நீளத்தில் கல் ஒன்றுக்கு விலை பணம் நாலாக, அரைமுழ கணத்தில் முக்கால் முழ பரப்பில் நாலு முழு நீளத்தில் கல் இருபதுக்கு பொன் எத்தனை? இஃப் த ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் அ ஸ்டோன் மெஷரிங் ஒன் ஃபோர்த் இன்டூ ஹாஃப் இன்டூ ஃபோர் இஸ் ஃபோர் பணம், வாட் இஸ் த ப்ரைஸ் ஆஃப் டுவெண்ட்டி ஸ்டோன்ஸ் மெஷரிங் ஹாஃப் இன்டூ த்ரீ ஃபோர்த் இன்டூ ஃபோர்? தி டயர் ப்ரொபோர்ஷன் price is equal to 20 into half into 3 fourth into 4 into 4 divided by 1 fourth into half into 4, which is 240 panam. Next. Ulvattam. This is Ulvattam and Puravattam are a little different from the usual mathematics. It is called Ulvattam when the shared amount is less than the total profit. So, for example, the profits have come to 120 and it is divided as a share of half, one-sixth, one-eighth and one-twelfth. That is 60, 20, 15 and 10. But if you add this up, it comes only to 105, not 120. So, this is called Ulvattam. The kanak is called Ulvattam. Next. புறவட்டம், இட் அக்கர்ஸ் வென் த ஷேர்ட் அமௌண்ட் எக்ஸீட்ஸ் த டோட்டல் ப்ராஃபிட்ஸ். குப்பம் ஒன்றில் நான்கு குடி நூற்றிருப்பதாகும், பொன் செப்பமுடன் பங்கிடுதல் செப்பொன்றால் தப்பறவே, இரண்டில் ஒன்று நான்கு எட்டில் ஒன்று ஆறு எத்திரண்ட பொன்னை நீ தெளிய செப்பு. செப்பு மீன் சொல்லு. இட் அக்கர்ஸ் வென் த ஷேர்ட் அமௌண்ட் எக்ஸீட்ஸ் த டோட்டல் ப்ராஃபிட். For the total profits of 120, if the shares are half, one-fourth, one-sixth and one-eighth, what does each one get? Adding one-half and one-fourth and one-sixth and one-eighth of 120, we get 125, which is more than 120. Actual share, therefore, should be 60 into 120 by 125, that the first man will get 57.5, the second man should get 28.8, the third man should get 19.2 and the fourth man should get 14.4. This is the actual share because the profits has exceeded 120, it has become 125. Next. Pangu Veedam, house of tax problem. House tax problem. குறுக்கமது மூன்றுக்கு கொற்றவனே தில் பணம், பெருக்கமுடம் ஏழாகும் பின்னுமதில் சுருக்கமாய், ஒன்றே அரைக்கால் குறுக உழுபவருக்கு தின்னமுடம் என்னதென்று செப்பு. இன் அ டவுன் தேர் வர் த்ரீ ஹோம்ஸ்டெட்ஸ். த டாக்ஸ் லெவிட் டு தெம் இன் டோட்டல் வாஸ் செவன் பணம். த ஷேர் ஆஃப் த டாக்ஸ் வாஸ் இன் த ப்ரொபோர்ஷன் ஒன் இஸ் டு ஹாஃப் இஸ் டு த்ரீ ஃபோர்த். ஹவு ஷுட் தே டிவைட் த டாக்ஸ்? த சொல்யூஷன், total tax levied is 7 panam, total of share 1 plus half plus 3 fourth, which is 7 by 4. Therefore, share of first person will be 1 by 7 by 4 into 7, which is 4. Second person will be half by 7 by 4 into 7, which is 2. And the share of third person would be half by 7 by 4 into 7 equals to 1. This is how it should be divided. Pangu Veedam. Next. Now we come to a very interesting section, which is called Maya Chaturam or Magic Square, called Bhadraganitam in Sanskrit. Now, this is a 4 into 4 grid and the numbers are filled up such that each row or each column would be equal to 34. Why 34? This is the 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 16 divided by 2, divided by 4. So each row or each column would be 34. Now, how are you going to place the numbers? So the schedule is given above. Shiriperum Yere Yere Yere, that is 14. Wondre directly written. Shiri Panirende 12. Yere is directly given. Yereperum Padinundre. Yel Padim Yette. And then Yel Padimundre. And then Rende. Per Perum Ainde. Yere Ainde Patte. Peru Mundre. Pin Yere at Padanare. Then Nale. And then move in the Padananju, and then R, Kuripidum, Unbode, Kadashile, 9, it ends with 9. So you place the numbers like this, and then you find if you add horizontally, if you add diagonally, or if you add vertically, it all adds up to 34. Please show. See, each of this will be 34. Next. The corners add up to 34. The sides add up to 34. The top and bottom add up to 34. The center square adds up to 34. One diagonal adds to 34. So, anyway you add, you get 34. This is a speciality of this Maya Chaturam. Now, interesting to note that the same magic square seen in the picture is a mirror image of the magic square given in the Tamil text. I had given this lecture in IIT Bombay, and a very good friend, Dr. Sharma, saw it in Düsseldorf, and then he sent this picture to me. He said, your magic square is this replica, the mirror image of this found in Khajuraho. Then I asked him, can I include it in my lecture? He said, definitely, because it is quite easily available in the net. Next. This is another one given in Nathana Kolakalam. It was very difficult to find the numbers, match the numbers with the Chayul. Finally, we found it. Mesha is the first Rashi in the zodiac. Ilakkadagamilika Jyoti Pattam. Jyoti is Swati. Swati is the 15th nakshatra, and then Patti directly. And Supradipa is the Diggaja. 8 Diggajas. One is Supradipa. And then Padinanke direct. Pundi is Budan, which is the 4th day of the week. Ponna is Guru, which is the 5th day of the week. And then Rashi, Kumbha Rashi is the 11th Rashi. And then Kari is 7. Mani is Navaratna 9. Chitrabanu, which is the 16th Samvatsara. So it is 16. Indu, 2nd day of the week. Meenam is the 12th Rashi. Velli is Shukra. Ararai is 3. And then Atta is Hasta, the 13th star. Thanks to Mr. V. R. Srinivasan, we figured it out and I filled up all the numbers. Next. So, this is a 9 into 9 grid and it is filled up with numbers from 1 to 81. So, 9 rows and 9 columns. So how to do this? So he has given a hint for that, and he has given a schedule for a 3x3 grid, and from which we can fill up the squares in a certain manner and get the 9x9 magic square. Next. இந்திரன் வாயு யமன் நிறுத்தி புது சந்திரனை சூடி தனபதியாம் முந்து கனல் வருணன் மற்றெழுது காரிக்கையார் தங்கள் இனமணி 81க்கு ஈ. ஸோ த 9 பிளேசஸ் யூ சி ஆர் த 9 டைரக்ஷன்ஸ் வித் த ஹோம் ஆர் த சென்டர். ஸோ தே ஆர் இன் த ஆர்டர், தி நம்பர்ஸ் ஹவ் டு பி ரிட்டன் இன் த ஆர்டர். இந்திரா 1, இந்திரா இஸ் ஈஸ்ட், இந்திரா 1. நார்த் வெஸ்ட் வாயு இஸ் 2, யமா சவுத் இஸ் 3, southwest niruti is 4, center is 5, ishana mula that is northeast is 6, kubera north is 7, and agni southeast is 8, and varuna west is varuna which is 9. So the square is 618 753 294. This is the 3x3. Okay, now you have to put it in the 9x9 grid. Next. So it is placed in the same order that you did. So the now if you add the numbers in the either vertically or horizontally, it comes to 369. How 369? 1 plus 2 plus up to 81 is 3321. Now you have it by divided by 9 to get the total of each column or row. So that comes to 369. You can add it up. You can see that it comes exactly to 369. Okay. Next. Now this 3x3 previous one, ma. Previous. Go back to the square. Previous one. Previous. 3x3. This 3x3 magic square, interestingly, is found in Palani and also here in Denupurishwara temple in Madambakkam. Next time you go to Denupurishwara temple in Madambakkam, it is in the entrance, this magic square is there. Very interesting. You can go and see it there. Next. Next one, Vonan Kanakku, the chameleon problem. The chameleon is trying to go up, but every time it falls down a little bit. Pathirindu panayai thendu munindhuruvan shaneri viral nalethaan eppavadu sendru uyirum endru munni endra mulathanai shan yetru edaan shan viral thaan panirendaga utra thogaiyai maari uyirum endre seppiyadhor iru naalvar kiya thondu serum naal innadendru cheppalame. A palm tree is 32 muram high. A chameleon climbed up the tree at the rate of 1 jan per day and climbed down 4 viral kadai per day. How many days does it take to reach the top? Next. So height of 32 muram is equal to 32 into 4 viral kadai. So it is 768 viral kadai. Height climbed by Onan in one day, 1 jan equal to 12 viral kadai. Height climbed down by Onan in one day, 4 viral kadai. So actually he is climbing only 8. Actual height climbed by Onan in one day is 12 minus 4, 8 viral kadai. So number of days taken by Onan to reach the top is 768 by 8, which is 96 days. Next. Kuruvi kanakku, the sparrow's problem. Sirudhu kuruvigal parandhu pochudhu. அதிலே ஒரு குருவி இருந்து 100 குருவிகளா 100 குருவிகளா நீங்கள் எத்தனை பேர்கள் என்று கேட்டது. நாங்களும் எங்களத்தனையும் எங்களில் பாதியும் பாதியில் பாதியும் நீயும் கூட்டினால் 100 என்று சொல்லி போட்டு போச்சுது. ஆனப்படியினாலே பறந்து போன குருவி எத்தனை? There were many sparrows on a tree and some flew away. A sparrow on the tree asked the sparrow which was flying away. You were 100. How many flew away? The second replied, add the same number flying away to itself, then its half, and then its 1/4, and yourself. The total is 100. How many flew away? Next. So let B be the number of sparrows which flew away. Then 100 is equal to B plus B plus half B plus 1/4 B plus 1. So 100 minus 1 is 2 1/3 AB. So B is equal to 36 sparrows. You can check it up. 36 plus itself 36 plus half 18 plus 1/4 9 plus 1 equal to 100. Next. தாமரைப்பூ கணக்கு. ஒரு பொய்கையிலே சிறிது தாமரைப்பூவிலே சிறிது குருவிகள் வந்து பூவுக்கு ஒரு குருவியாக இருந்தது. அதிலே ஒரு குருவிக்கு இருக்க பூவில்லை. ஆனபடியினாலே திரும்ப பறந்து பூவுக்கு இரண்டு குருவியாக இருந்தது. அதன் பேரிலே ஒரு பூ பிச்சமாயிருந்தது. ஆனபடியினாலே வாவியில் இருந்த பூ எத்தனை குருவி எத்தனை என்றால் பூ 3 குருவி 4 என்பது. The answer is given along with the problem. So I have just worked it out. There were some birds and some flowers. If the birds sat one each on each flower, there was no flower for one bird. On the other hand, if they sat two each on each flower, there was no bird for one flower. How many were the birds and how many were the flowers? So let the birds be B and the flowers be F. B minus F equal to 1 will be the first equation. And F minus B by 2 equal to 1 will be the second equation. So adding 1 and 2, the F is going to get cancelled. So B minus B by 2 equal to 2, or B is equal to 4, and therefore F is equal to 3. You can check the answer is correct. Next. Pookal kanakku. In a village, there's a very similar problem in the text Dr. Balasubramanian mentioned, my thesis, Bija Pallava, that's a similar problem. In a village, there was a Ganapati temple and a garden of flowers. The priest dipped the flowers in the tank where it doubled. He offered some flowers in the first temple. With the remaining, he went to the second temple. He doubled in the tank and he gave the same number of flowers to the god. With the remaining, he went to the third temple. It doubled the tank and he gave the same number of flowers to the god. Now he had no flowers left. How many did he have initially? And how many did he offer to the Lord each time? Next. So let the initial number of flowers be X and flowers offered to the God be Y. In the tank, the flowers became 2X and offered to first Ganapati Y. So remainder will be 2X minus Y. This will become double. In the second time, they became 4X minus 2Y. The remainder after offering to second Ganapati, this 4x minus 3y. In the third tank, this will become 8x minus 6y. And remainder after offering to third Ganapati, 8x minus 7y. Now he says there were no flowers left. So 8x minus 7y equals 0, or x and y are in the proportion of 7 and 8. So flowers plucked initially is 7, and flowers offered to God each time will be 8. Next. கால்நடை கணக்கு அனிமல்ஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் தேர் மெனி ப்ராப்ளம் ஜஸ்ட் ஒன் ஆஃப் தெம் யானைக்கு ஒன்றுக்கு பணம் 5 குதிரைக்கு ஒன்றுக்கு பணம் 3/4 ஆடு ஒன்றுக்கு பணம் 1/4 பணமும் 100 இருக்க வேண்டும் உருப்படியும் 100 இருக்க வேண்டும் ஸோ இஃப் த நம்பர் ஆஃப் அனிமல்ஸ் பாட் இஸ் 100 அண்ட் த டோட்டல் பணம் ஸ்பெண்ட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ 100 ஃபைண்ட் த நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஈச் அனிமல் அண்ட் இட்ஸ் காஸ்ட் ஸோ தெர் ஆர் மெனி ஆன்சர்ஸ் டு திஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் ஸோ ஐ ஹவ் ஜஸ்ட் கிவன் 1 12 elephants at the rate of 5 panam will be 60. 36 horses at the rate of 3/4 panam will be 27. And 52 goats at the rate of 1/4 panam will be 13. So total number of animals is 100. Total money paid is 100 panam. Next. எறும்பு கணக்கு. இலங்கையில் வீதி சுத்தும் 700 காதம் உண்டு வழியில் இடைவிடாமல் மிக ஏறும் முருங்காய் செல்லும் வலங்கையிலே விரலே வைத்தேன் வைத்ததில் எறும்பே 7 இலங்கையில் வீதி சுத்தும் எறும்புகள் என்னாய் நீரே ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஐவ் டேக்கன் திஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் டு ஷோ த டினாமினேஷன் தி லீனியர் மெஷர்ஸ் 12 விரல் ஈக்குவல் டு 1 ஷான் 2 shan equal to 1 muram, 2 muram equal to 1 shirukol, 4 shirukol equal to 1 perungol, 500 perungol equal to kupidu. We kupidu, we thought it was calling, it's actually a measure. 4 kupidu equal to 1 kadam, kadam, and 1 kadam equal to 384,000 viral kadai. So number of ants in 384,000 viral kadai or 1 kadam is this big 26 lakh, some big number. So number of ants in 700 kadams will be 188,16,000,000. So many ants. This is just an interesting problem to show the combination. Pon kattigal kanakku, chettiyar's gold bar. A chettiyar kattiyor ettu maathu kaalare mukkalagum, chettiyar settu ponar. சிறுபிள்ளை மூன்று பேரும் வெட்டியும் மகரொன்னாது விலையுமோ குறையொன்னாது வெட்டி சுட்டியாய் பகரவல்லார் கணக்கா கணக்கர் கோடாலி ஆமே கோடாலி என் கணக்கு தென் யூ கேன் சால்வ் திஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் செட்டியார் ஹட் த்ரீ சன் ஹீ டைட் ஒன் டே லீவிங் பிஹைண்ட் சம் கோல்ட் தேர் எயிட் பாஸ் ஈச் ஆஃப் ஒன் ஃபோர்த் மாத்து ஹாஃப் மாத்து அண்ட் த்ரீ ஃபோர்த் மாத்து வித்தவுட் பிரேக்கிங் த பார்ஸ் The three had to divide the bars equitably among themselves. How did they do it? So we know only that number of maathu in all will be 8 into half plus 8 into 1 fourth plus 8 into 3 fourth, which is equal to 12. Next. So I have worked it out in a matrix so that the answer comes easily. This is the matrix. So each 8, we cannot cut the bars, but in the same time, they have to get equally. So they have got equally here. Next. Muttu kadakku, tradesman's pearls. A tradesman left, leaving a heap of pearls for his 7 heirs. Initially, 2 sons wanted to divide it between themselves. There was one remaining. Similarly, 3, 4, 5, 6 sons tried to divide it among themselves. Each time there was one remaining. But there was no remainder when 7 sons divided it. How many pearls were there in all? ஆனபடியினாலே செட்டியார் வச்சிப்போன ஆசித்தி இருந்த முத்து எத்தனை என்றால் முத்து 301 பங்கு நிரந்தரமாக முத்து அறியும்படி. So how should you do it? You have given the answer, but I have worked out the method to find it. At first, the LCM of 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 is found and it is equal to 60. The required answer should be a number which is a multiple of 60 added to 1 and the whole divisible by 7. Next. So, we can solve this by Kuttaka or the Indian method of solving indeterminate equation of the first degree. That is called Kuttaka. So, the equation is 60x plus 1 equal to 7y. So, you get the answer is y is equal to 60 minus 7 to 43, x is equal to 5. Therefore, the number of pearls is equal to 7 into 43 or 60 into 5 plus 1, which is both are equal to 301. There are many answers to this, but the least of such numbers is 301, which is what is given in the example. Next. Modira kanakku. Muppadanal sevithaan thanakku thanum ugiyamal arendu muremayaga sheppamudam inainda vidam pesa vendral thiramaga modirathai ainde sherir ஒப்பமுடம் 1, 2, 4, 8 முகந்ததொரு 15 முகந்தே செய்யில் எப்ப வந்து சேவித்தான் கேட்டானால் இயலாம் மோதிரத்தை என்றும் தானே. நெக்ஸ்ட். The king had a worker working for him at the rate of 1 விராகன் per day. At the end of the month, his wages would be 30 விராகன். The worker made a condition that the king would pay him his wages on any day that he stopped work. So the king made for himself 5 rings of different virahan so that the worker would be paid on any day. What were the 5 different rings made? The answer is given in the schedule. Five rings are of one virahan, two virahan, four virahan, eight virahan, and 15 virahan. For example, if the payment had to be done on the first day, she would give the one virahan ring. If he wants on the second day, he will give the two virahan ring. If he wants on the fifth day, he will give the four virahan ring and a one virahan. If it's on the 10th day, it will be 8 and 2. And if it wants on the 20th day, it would be 15, 4 and 1. Like this, he is prepared to give the worker any day of the month he has by having these five kinds of rings. Next. யானைகள் கணக்கு. பத்து மதிலுடைய பார்வேந்தன் வாசலிலே வைத்த மதிலளவே வாசலாம் இச்சையுடன் முன்னீர் உண்ண உகந்து வரும் யானை எண்ணியிட ஏழாண்டும் செல்லும். A fort had 10 gates. A number of elephants passed through the first gate. The next day, an equal number passed through the second gate. Then 3, then 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And on the 10th day, they passed through the 10 gates, equal number in each. What was the total number of elephants? It is obvious that it is an LCM of, number should be divisible by 2, 3 up to 10. So the answer is the LCM, which amounts to 2520 elephants. Next. வேடன் கணக்கு. புத்ததோர் காதம் காதம் ஒருபடியடி போல் வேடன் நீத்தலும் நடத்தல் வேண்டும் நெடுநாள் ஐந்து காதம். அத்தனை இரட்டி செய்தே இதுதானில் ஒன்று நீக்கி சுத்தமாய் கண்டு ரத்தன சுருக்கதே துணிந்து பாரேன். A boar ran 20 kadams each day for many days. A hunter was following the boar, covering 1 kadam on the first day, 2 kadams on the second day, and so on. On which day did he catch the boar? The answer is also given. If 20 is the kadams covered by the boar in one day, the number of days is 2 into 20 minus 1, which is 39. Next. I have given the working. If n be the number of days and k the number of kadams per day, distance covered by the boar in n days equal to k into n. Distance covered by the hunter in n days is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. Now, equating both, you get n is equal to 2k minus 1. Here, k is 20. So, n is equal to 2 into 20 minus 1 equals to 39 days. Next. So, I'm concluding my talk. These are some of the examples I have taken from the text Aasthana Kolagalam. There are many more interesting examples from day-to-day life. We get also an idea of the social life in those days, the monies that were used, the measures that they were used in those days. Aasthana Kolagalam itself can be translated as giving delight to the audience. It delights the enthusiasts and prompts the researchers of mathematics. The editor averse. This is half evident as a Hastamalaka or Myrobalan in the hand. My request is this so rare to get. We have so far had access only to Aasthana Kolagalam and a text Kanakadigaram. If anybody could come across any other text in Tamil dealing with mathematics, please come forward and give it to us. We will work on it. Thank you. Thanks, KSRA, for giving me this opportunity to share my Aasthana Kolagalam with everyone.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much. It was a nice lecture. I think everybody enjoyed it, especially Mr. P.R. Kannan, who was going through the videos and the maths. I was noticing his face. He was interested in that dance Kanaku when it came. He was very much interested. He was talking to somebody, saying something. Yes, sir. Am I right? Yeah, he's
sure,
laughing.
Yeah, sure, sure, sure. Yeah.
Yeah. It's very nice text. These two texts, which they had worked at the KSRA. We all have listened to them, worked with them, and we have listened to these verses often and on, and it is very, very interesting. Though they are not like textbooks. they have sums, they have problems, they give problems and solutions in pithy verse forms, so that it one has to work it out and then find the answers and everything. And it was very well done by this by Dr. Sita Sundararaman. She was the pathbreaker in 2000 she joined at KSRA, and then 2007 she came with her degree, I think 2007 madam or 9.
Yes, 2007.
Yeah, she came
got
with
my the degree in 2008.
Yeah, and from then on she had been making it her job to propagate these texts everywhere, both Sanskrit and Tamil. We do not we don't shy away from Tamil. We bring it out very much to the fore, and then people will have to know that both the languages have are treasures of knowledge, and we have to delve deep into these things to bring out the treasures out and show it to the world, which Dr. Sita Sundaram had been doing, and after her Dr. Rama Kalyani had also been following her step and going with her to so many places and propagate these things. And after her we have got about 4 people doing mathematics at present in KSRA. We are very happy that we have done this path breaking research. And today I think we can boldly say that we have really achieved something in this field. Though we do not profess in astronomy, we are Dr. Sita Sundararaman, Dr. Rama Kalyani are experts in both algebra and arithmetic, and they have done a wonderful job. And anybody need to have any clarification before we close? Mr. Kannan?
No, it was very interesting. I recorded in my chat.
Very good.
Extremely nice lecture. Very nicely presented. Very interestingly presented. Yes. Very difficult subject. Very difficult subject. Very rank subject.
Thank you, sir.
It's actually simple, which we have done in our school times. Only thing is, it is in half Tamil, which we are a bit we take a bit of time to break it and understand it, which she has done with English translation. What about Professor Thyagarajan? Did you do the sums, sir? You said you had paper and pen ready. Professor Thyagarajan.
Oh.
Kanakala potta.
I should say that it's a brain warming.
It was an excellent lecture.
While you were talking about yanaigal kanakku, in the PPT, it is with the diagram you brought, it shows as yanaikal kanakku.
Yanaikal kanakku, yes. Yanaikal
means yanaigal kanakku.
It is yanaigal kanakku.
If there is case in English translation, it is elephants mathematics.
It's yanaigal kanakku. Yeah, the diacritical was wrong.
Yanaigal kanakku.
Please remove that diagram marks.
She'll do that, yes.
Okay, that's all. That's all. Nothing more.
Okay.
Quite interesting.
Ma'am, it was an excellent lecture. We got to hear her one more time. Brilliant presentation. Nallavela, she did not ask us who only know Sanskrit to have solved this problem. I thank her for giving all the answers promptly. Thank you so much, ma'am.
That's Anusha for you. Good. Anybody? Yes, Anusha. V. Anusha.
V. Anusha, ma'am.
V. Anusha, yes, yes. Very rare to come and attend the lecture because it is not a Saturday you are here. Good.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Good evening, ma'am.
Yes.
I am Prabha from Ethiraj College, yes. Colleague of Anusha.
Yes.
I am heading the Department of Mathematics in Ethiraj College. I was very delighted. Actually, I know little bit of Sanskrit, and I am also very much interested in Tamil. Tamilum kanidamum senda idala nano நிறைய எங்கெங்கெல்லாம் திருக்குறள் அந்த மாதிரி இடத்துல எல்லாம் எப்படி எண்களை பத்திலாம் இருக்கு அப்படின்றதும் நானும் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டா நிறைய ஒப்சர்வ் பண்ணி வச்சிருந்திருக்கேன். ஸோ திஸ் லெக்சர் வாஸ் ரியலி அன் ஐ ஓபனர் ஃபார் மீ. அண்ட் ஆக்சுவலி ஐ ஹட் லாங் பிஃபோர் ஐ ஹட் ரெட் அ ஃபன் வித் மேக்ஸ் ஒன் ரஷ்யன் புக். ஆக்சுவலி நவ் ஐ ஃபைண்ட் மெனி திங்ஸ் ஹியர் சிமிலர் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் விச் தே ஹட் ஒர்க் அவுட். ma'am had also touched. So it's really, I could recall that actually.
That's nice. That is a good information. Can you pass on that information to us, that Russian book?
Yeah.
You can get the email ID from Anusha.
Yeah,
please send us the information, right?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Dr. Sita, you are not there.
I'm here.
You are not seen on the screen. Yes.
I will ask just two questions.
Please.
About the days, do we consider Tingal as the number two? I mean, we start with Nyayari in Tamil.
Yes.
Yes. That is how we have given the number. That is why.
Because generally we go by Monday, Tuesday, like that. Sunday comes in the last.
Nyayari illa da aramikkirathu. Srinivasan sir, solunga. Yes, Srinivasan. Number one, number potom.
Illa Nyayari da Adivaram.
Indian tradition la Nyayiru dhaan first. Not like the Western tradition where it is a sabbatical day.
I'll have to check. Adhu Tamil la andha maari edhaavadhu reference irukkaanu paakkanum. Andha idhukku appo innum neenga andha palapala kanakku solumbodhu n into 64 by 8 solinga.
Appadi avan kuduthirukka adhu pesam 8 ala multiply panna porom.
ஞாபகம்
தமிழ்ல
பாட்டுல
எப்படி ஒண்ணா பாடலாம் சார், சந்தஸ்காக சான்ஸ்கிரிட்ல கூட எப்படி ஒண்ணா பண்ணுவா, அது வந்து ப்ரூஃப் கிடையாது. ஞாயிறு
கிரகங்களை சொல்லும் போதே இந்த லைன்ல தானே சொல்லிருக்காரு அவரு.
மச்ச குடும்ப வராக சொல்லி வரோம், மச்சிய அவதாரம் முதல் இல்லை
அப்படின்னு
அந்த மாதிரி இல்ல சொல்றேன் அவரு. ஹி ப்ரூவ்ஸ் இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி வராக ஞாயிறு திங்கள் பாட்டுல வருது, அதனால அது முதல்ல இருக்கான்றதுக்கு அது நம்பர் ஒன் இல்ல பூத சங்கியாலயோ வேற எதுலயோ ஒன்று அது ஒன் டூ த்ரீ அது மாதிரி இருக்கான்.
ஒரு விஷயம் கேஎஸ்பி, நம்ம வீட்டுல எல்லாம் வந்து கிழமைகள் சொல்லி தரும் போதே குழந்தைகளுக்கு சொல்லி தச்சு மாசமும் வாரம் அதெல்லாம் சொல்லும் போது ஞாயிறு தான் சொல்லி சொல்லி
சொல்லும்பொழுது சூரியன்ல இருந்து இருக்கக்கூடிய கிரகங்களை ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ஐ மீன் எனக்கு இப்ப எக்ஸாக்ட்னு அதுக்குள்ள போல டீடைல் அந்த டைம் ஆகும்ங்கிறதுனால அண்ட் இட் மே ரெக்வயர் ஐ மீன் ஒன் டயக்ராம்ஸ். அவ வந்து என்ன பண்ணிருக்கான்னா ஏழு குறையா பிரிச்சிருக்கா, ஏழு குறையா பிரிச்சுட்டு ஒரு குறைக்கு அடுத்தது ரெண்டாவது குறை மூணாவது குறைன்னு அந்த குறைய கணக்கு பண்றா. அப்படி கணக்கு பண்ணும்போது தே டேக் இட் ஏ பர்டிகுலர் டிஸ்டன்ஸ், அந்த டிஸ்டன்ஸ்ல என்ன ஆகுதுன்னா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் குறை வந்து சன் வருது, அதுல இருந்து 24 குறையும் போட்டு வரும்போது 25வது குறையா மூன் வருது,
மூன் வருது,
மூன்ல இருந்து 24 குறை போடும்போது அதுக்கடுத்து மார்ஸ், இந்த மாதிரி வரதுனால தான் இப்ப இருக்கிற கிழமைகள் வந்து ஞாயிறு திங்கள் செவ்வாய் அப்படின்னு நம்ம அரேஞ்ச் பண்ணிருக்கோம்ட்டு அந்த ஹோரா டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஹோரா டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிளஸ் ஹோரா கால்குலேஷன் அது மேலதான் இந்த ஏழு நாளுடைய இது இருக்கு அந்த இடத்துல எனக்கு இப்ப இம்மிடியா கேட்டா ஐ வில் பி ஏபிள் டு டிஸ்கிரைப் புட் இன் எ டிஃபிகல்ட் சிச்சுவேஷன் பட் திஸ் இஸ் ஹவ் தி ஹோரா கால்குலேஷன் இஸ் டன் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் as well as 24
this is news to us good
but standard we have been taking nyayira at the beginning of the week
this I have learned
in the magic square panirukku
this I have learned it from Dr. Sundaram the chemistry professor of college
okay ama he was our astrologer ache so he would have known
he has written a dictionary also dictionary of astrology
yes thank you madam so I'll wind up for the day
so
it
has created lot of interest now
அவ்வளவு இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இல்லைனா செப்டர் ஞாபகம் இல்ல ஃபுல்லா அதை ரீகவுண்ட் பண்றதுக்கு பட் திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு ஹி டோல்ட் மீ ஹவு வீக் டேஸ்